अगर लोग खाना नहीं खा सकते, बाथरूम नहीं जा सकते, आपको बताया वी कान फॉर 2 आवर्स वी गेट अन डम्प, मतलब 16 आवर्स एक ही ऊपर एक डम्प, एंड देयर इज नो ऑक्सीजन फॉर देम टू ब्रीद इन. अभी जो लड़कियां वो टैंकर में जा रही है उनके तो रिकॉर्ड्स नहीं है. सो यू आर 32,000 ऑफ दोस 16 देयर आर गोइंग एवरी डे, देयर आर नो रिटन रिकॉर्ड्स ऑफ दैट. एंड व्हेन यू रिमूव दोस बॉडीज, जैसे हम लोग वॉशिंग मशीन से कपड़े निकालते हैं, हाफ दोस बॉडीज आर ब्रोकन बोन्स राइट, बिकॉज एस ए यू स्टफ देम इन. सो बॉडीज विद मैंगल्ड बोन्स कम आउट, आधे मर चुके हैं, आधे आधे जिंदे आधे मरे. कुछ बच्चों को ऑक्सीजन नहीं मिला है तो दे आर हाफ डेड हाफ अलाइव, तो यूज नहीं होंगे वो टू बिकम टेररिस्ट इन द फ्यूचर. एंड जो औरतें थोड़ी तंदुरुस्त है और सेक्स स्लेव्स बन सकती है उनको लिया जाता है एंड भर्ती किया जाता है आईएसआईएस कैंप में. जो बच्चे शायद बड़े होकर टेररिस्ट बन सकते हैं, वो जो आधे फॉर यूज नहीं है टू बिकम सुसाइड बॉम्बर्स और सेक्स स्लेव्स, उनको ऐसे ही रेगिस्तान में वो मर जाते हैं बिकॉज दे वोंट बी ऑफ एनी यूज. सो देन आई थिंक अब जब लोगों को कोई नंबर पूछता है, एंड जैसे हमारी फिल्म में एक सीन है नीमा मैथ्यूज का, जो वो अपना केस रजिस्टर करने जा रही है, शी इज बीन रेप्ड बाय 15 to 20 people एवरी डे, एंड दे आस्क हर प्रूफ. अभी किसी ने आपको 15 लोगों ने आपको रेप किया, आई डोंट नो प्रूफ कैसे दोगे आप, हाउ डू यू गिव प्रूफ दैट यू हैव बीन रेप कंटिन्यूअसली फॉर अ मंथ बाय 15 people per day, थोड़ा मुश्किल होगा. वो शालिनी के साथ प्यार में धोखा हुआ, तो अगर प्यार में धोखा हुआ है तो वो केस कैसे रजिस्टर किया जाता है कि किसी ने प्यार में मुझे धोखा दिया. आई डोंट नो कैसे रजिस्टर किया जाता है, क्या वो काउंटेड नहीं होता, क्या रेप काउंटेड नहीं होता, बिकॉज हम लोग लिख के नहीं प्रूव कर सकते हैं कि यहाँ की पोजिशन में ये लड़के ने ये किया और वो लड़के ने उसके बाद तुरंत वो किया. कैसे लिखा जा सकता है और कैसे कंप्लेन, हाउ डज वन टेल समबडी दैट दिस इज द प्रूफ, आई डोंट नो. सो इतने सारे सवाल, एंड व्हेन आई मेट ऑल ऑफ दीज गर्ल्स आई सॉ कितने स्ट्रांग है ये, बिकॉज आई वॉज आस्क दीज क्वेश्चन नाउ जब मैं प्रमोट कर रही थी अपनी फिल्म को. एंड मैं एक एक्टर हूँ एंड मैं एक लड़की हूँ, आई कुड फील देयर पेन एज अ गर्ल, बट द क्वेश्चन दैट वर आस्क्ड टू मी सम ऑफ देम आई शुड फील लाइक हाउ कैन यू आस्क दिस. आई मीन आप देख रहे हो लाइक देयर इज अ सीन वेयर सच ग्राफिक वायलेंस हो रहा है, बट यू सीन आर यू श्योर अबाउट द नंबर, कैन यू प्रूव द रेप हाउ इट हैपेंड, यू नो. आई एम श्योर यू दीज गर्ल्स रियली नीड अ ह्यूज हैंड ऑफ अप्लॉज फॉर कमिंग हियर एंड सिटिंग हियर इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू गाइस and being able to tell you their stories, knowing that they will be judged, knowing that they will be nitpicked, knowing that they will be asked questions that are personal questions that are degrading, questions that are to make them feel really small, to make them feel like they're inconsequential, because when you go through something like rape and when you go through something like indoctrination and when someone's messed with your mind, stripped you of your self-confidence, and then when someone makes you feel really small, they still come here knowing that anyone could ask them anything, knowing that. So to be part of this project is I think we are all very very fortunate that Dubos and Speakers have gave us this opportunity.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we've had the ladies speak. It's a film about the ladies. I think of that wonderful
watching documentaries and watching shows. अपनी नॉर्मल लाइफ से जो मोह होना है ना वो चला जाता है, बिकॉज व्हाट दे आर गोइंग थ्रू व्हाट द पेन दे हैव फेल्ट, आई थिंक वी जस्ट वांटेड टू डेडिकेट ऑल आवर एनर्जी सो दैट व्हेन दे वॉच दिस फिल्म वी डू जस्टिस फॉर इट. दैट इज ऑल वी वांटेड टू डू थ्रू दिस फिल्म. जैसे बिल्कुल समय का हम स्टार्ट में जब ये स्टोरी के बारे में पढ़ रहे थे देख रहे थे तब इतना नहीं पता था. कन्वर्जन ऑफ कोर्स सबको पता है कि होते हैं और अगर आप अपनी खुद के चॉइस से कन्वर्ट हो रहे हो देन आई डोंट सी एनी प्रॉब्लम. लेकिन फोर्स कन्वर्जन दैट टू अगर आपको आईएसआईएस का पार्ट या टेररिस्ट ग्रुप का पार्ट बनाया जाए ये बहुत गलत है. तो जब हम लोग स्क्रिप्ट पढ़ रहे थे वी वर नंब ऑल फोर ऑफ अस, जब हमें सुदीप तो सर ने कुछ पिक्चर्स कुछ वीडियोज कुछ डिटेल्स बताई थी क्योंकि ही इज बीन रिसर्चिंग ऑन द टॉपिक फॉर 7 इयर्स नाउ, तो ऑफकोर्स उतनी रिसर्च हम एक महीने में नहीं कर सकते थे. लेकिन ज्यादातर फिल्म आपके कैरेक्टर के बारे में होती है कि हम कैरेक्टर कैसे प्रेप करेंगे कैसे एक्टिंग करेंगे कैसे उस, लेकिन ये फिल्म कहीं से भी बार प्रोजेक्ट वाइज नहीं था, डे वन से उन लड़कियों के बारे में था, क्योंकि सुदीप्त सर मेड श्योर कि जब हम उन सब के बारे में जाने तो इट वॉजेंट अ कमर्शियल प्रोजेक्ट ऑनेस्टली स्पीकिंग. आज भी लोग पूछ रहे हैं कि 100 करोड़ हो गया, 150 करोड़ हो गया, आपको कैसा लग रहा है. ट्रस्ट मी, हम लोग सब अगर चाहते तो उतना बिजनेस हो चुका है कि आज ये सब करने का कोई पॉइंट नहीं है, लेकिन कहीं ना कहीं हम इतना अटैच हैं इस प्रोजेक्ट से. वी फील सो मच अबाउट द प्रोजेक्ट कि आज भी हम लोग यहाँ पर हैं. और जैसा आपने पूछा कि पढ़ने के बाद, आई थिंक वी आर ऑल डिफरेंट पर्सन नाउ, ऑल ऑफ अस, क्योंकि हम डे वन पे जब प्रोजेक्ट पे थे तब बहुत एक्टर एक्टर वाली फीलिंग थी, पर आज हम पर्सनली बहुत जुड़े हुए हैं इस प्रोजेक्ट के सब लोगों के साथ.
सो मेरे लिए ये मेरी पहली हिंदी पिक्चर है और ये एक सब्जेक्ट है जो एक एज एन एक्टर एज अ प्रोफेशनल मैं बताना चाहूंगी कि मोस्ट वो स्टीरियोटिपिकल सब्जेक्ट नहीं है. हीरो हीरोइन वैसा जो हमें सोचते हैं, जिसका ड्रीम रहता है कि अरे मैं पिक्चर करूंगी तो ऐसी पिक्चर करूंगी, इसके साथ करूंगी, मगर लाइफ में ऐसे मौके बहुत कम मिलते हैं जहाँ ये आपसे भी बड़ी चीज है. ऐसा मौका है कि ये जो स्टोरी है वो हम चारों का जितने भी कास्ट मेंबर है उनके थ्रू हर एक लड़की को पहुंचे जो शायद इस चीज से गुजर रही है या गुजर चुकी हो, और उसकी अगर मदद हो सके एक भी लड़की की तो ये हमारे लिए बहुत बहुत बड़ी जीत है. सेकेंडली, मैं कल अपनी नानी के साथ ये पिक्चर देखने गई थी और मेरी नानी गुजराती है, ज्यादा हिंदी समझती नहीं है. उन्होंने बाहर आके मुझे एक बार बोली कि मुझे वो तेरा सीन बहुत सही लगा जब तूने आके अपने पापा को बताया कि आपने तो हमें कभी कुछ सिखाया ही नहीं, जो कि मैं मानती हूँ बहुत बहुत ज्यादा सच बात है. क्योंकि आज भी मैं अपनी नानी को पूछती हूँ कि ऐसा क्यों है, ये क्यों होता है, हम मंडे को क्यों व्रत रखते हैं, हम ट्यूजडे को क्यों व्रत रखते हैं. वो बोलती है बस ऐसा ही है, मेरे टाइम से उनके पापा दादा सबके टाइम से यही चला जा रहा है. तो हमें ज्यादा नॉलेज नहीं है जो कि इस पिक्चर से मुझे रियलाइज हुआ है. और एक चीज, एक मुस्लिम लेडी आई थी कल मेरे पास पिक्चर लेने आई थी और आगे उन्होंने मेरा हाथ शेक किया और मुझे बहुत टाइट हग किया और मुझे बोला थैंक यू कि आपने ये पिक्चर दिखाई है, क्योंकि ये पिक्चर इस्लाम को गलत नहीं बता रहा है बट ये बता रहा है कि कुछ लोग इस्लाम को यूज करके उसका कितना गलत फायदा उठा रहे हैं टेररिज्म के लिए. और मैं मानती हूँ कि टेररिज्म का कोई भी रिलीजन नहीं होता.
एक चीज और ऐड करना चाहूंगी मैं, कन्वर्जन के बारे में हम लोग बार बार बात कर रहे हैं. ऐसा नहीं है कि हम किसी कम्युनिटी को टारगेट कर रहे हैं, लेकिन मेरा आप सबसे क्वेश्चन है, हम कन्वर्जन अगर करते हैं हिंदू में या सिख में या क्रिश्चियनिटी में, पॉइंट कन्वर्जन का नहीं है. ऐसा कहाँ होता है कि ISIS और टेररिज्म का पार्ट बन जाए, ऐसा कभी भी नहीं होता और किसी कन्वर्जन में. क्योंकि इस फिल्म के ड्यूरेशन में ऑफकोर्स लाइक आई सेड आपको भी अपना थोड़ा रिसर्च करना पड़ता है. आई वॉज रिसर्चिंग, कन्वर्जन हिंदुइज्म में भी बहुत हुए हैं केरला में, लेकिन पॉइंट वहां पे आ रहा है कि कन्वर्ट करके आप किसी टेररिस्ट ग्रुप का पार्ट बना रहे हो, ISIS का पार्ट बना रहे हो, दैट इज वेयर दे आर रॉन्ग आई थिंक.
बिफोर वी स्टार्ट द फिल्म, सुदीप सर ने मुझे एक वीडियो दिखाया था जहाँ पे लड़कियां और औरतें और बच्चों को एक टैंकर में, जैसे वॉशिंग मशीन में हम लोग कपड़े स्टफ करते हैं ना, वैसे 16 आवर्स बाय रोड.
आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक द होल टीम फॉर टू थिंग्स. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, giving us this beautiful movie. The movie succeeded in depicting what is the brainwashing system existing all over the world, not only in Kerala but all over the world. And it is succeeded in depicting what is love trap jihadis. And the movie got succeeded in depicting what the recruiting system existing in our country, which is recruiting the people towards ISIS like terrorism groups. And the movie got success in showing what the problem is and where the solution is. Problem kya tha? Shalini Unnikrishnan ka aur Geetanjali ka.
प्रॉब्लम धर्म सिखाए गए नहीं है और चरित्र के बारे में कुछ भी नहीं सिखाए गए हैं. दे वर नॉट नोइंग व्हाट इज हैपनिंग इन एंड अराउंड ऑफ बर्थ एंड दे कुड इजली बिकम प्रे टू व्हाट द अदर द एंटागोनिस्ट कैरेक्टर वाज ट्राइंग एंड सॉल्यूशन आल्सो सेड इन द सेम मूवी आल्सो. सो वी ऑल as representatives of victim of all types of jihad are thanking Vipul ji, Sudipta ji and all the team, Ara ji and all. Thank you to you showing how those people could brainwash us, how they could inject poisonous ideologies in our brain. And thank you to showing what was our situation when we got brainwashed. Thank you all. And we all from Asham Vidya Samajam thanking our father, our guru, Acharya Shri K.R. Manoji and our second mother, Asham Vidya Samajam, to bring him back to life. To declare in front of you, standing boldly, we had such experience. Nobody should come to this experience. No more Shruti, no more Chitra, no more Ahira, no more Dr. Anatha should come. We will fight. Thank you for supporting us. Thank you. Thank you all also. We will fight. We Asham Vidya Samajam Association team seeking help from other organizations also. We fight against these anti-nationals. We will not allow anybody to become prey again. We will fight. Please support us. Thank you. Thank you all.
Thank you very much for that. Very
good. Statement in a press conference. Pinarayi Vijayan, who was speaking in the context of narcotic jihad, had revealed that Praju, a resident of Turutia and Parucheri, was included in the list of Malayalis who joined the IS. Praju Muhammad Amin, who is also accused in the Tirunur Mangayam Amina Uma murder case, fled the country after causing a huge financial burden on his wife and family. The wife says that it is no surprise that he has joined a terrorist organization because he would do anything for money. He has married 4 times. Praju converted to Islam 3 years before marrying her. The young woman revealed that the man who had strong religious beliefs had forced her, a Sunni believer, to be radical in her beliefs and told her that if she did so, she would get money as she wished. In 2009, Amina Uma, an elderly woman, was murdered by living alone in her house in Mangayam, Variamala. Due to lack of evidence, the court acquitted Praju and another accused, that is in the murder case, due to lack of evidence. This was mentioned to the Chief Minister of Kerala himself. We have different cases recorded, evidence which was reported in news itself of different people who converted or got radicalized, or people who belong to a certain community or region themselves who got radicalized and joined terrorist organization. Not just IS but other terrorist organizations also. Not just that, there is recorded evidence of cases of love jihad in which the girl are found dead in suspicious situations. For example, Anila Veni Juli, students of Ambalapura, all this is related to Kerala. Anila Veni Juli, students of Ambalapura Model Higher Secondary School. Vrinda Papineshwari Kannur. We have at least 18 such cases of reported suspicious deaths linked with love jihad and other killings.
Hi, this is Suna from Webinya. Director sahab, I will definitely say 32,000 या 25,000 या 30,000 माइनिंग क्राइम रहता है जो 3 या 4 लड़कियों के साथ हुआ है वो भी क्राइम है और नंबर्स डेफिनेटली डज नॉट डिसाइड की क्राइम की ग्रेविटी क्या होगी. यहाँ पर मैं आपके साथ ही श्रुति या चित्रा जो भी जवाब देना चाहें. आप चूंकि पढ़ाई के जरिए लोगों को वापस सनातन धर्म या अपने किसी और धर्म में लाने की कोशिश कर रही हैं, तो क्या पढ़ाया जाता है और क्या दिखाया जाता है कि क्या सही है और गलत है।
हेलो, सी व्हेन अ पर्सन हु हैज बीन रेडिकलाइज्ड और ब्रेनवॉश्ड टू अ सर्टेन आइडियोलॉजी इज ब्रॉट टू आवर इंस्टीट्यूशन, दे आर इन अ पर्टिकुलर माइंड सेट दैट दे आर नॉट इवन विलिंग टू कॉन्वर्स विद अस। इफ यू टेल देम, इफ यू ट्राई टू टेल देम मॉरल्स और इफ यू ट्राई टू टेल देम समथिंग अबाउट गुड वैल्यूज और समथिंग, दे आर नॉट विलिंग टू लिसन। दे से आई डोंट वांट टू लिसन to something related to Hindu dharma, I do not want you to post from Vedas, I do not want you to want to hear anything from the Bhagavad Gita, I want to talk only on the basis of the Quran and the other authentic scriptures of Islam. So that is where the challenge is. So unless we ourselves are not well versed, so we haven't learned the scriptures, authentic scriptures which are leading these people, or certain verses from the authentic scriptures which is motivating these people into adopting radical or anti-national mindsets, and counsel them and bring them back by telling them how fallacious these are or how dangerous these are or how they have been fooled or brainwashed into believing that something like this is the words of God or divine inspiration. We have to know ourselves, or we have to be educated ourselves. So what we, answering your question, what we do, how we do, we counsel them based on comparative religion. That is, along with Sanatana Dharma, we also teach or we also impart teachings in the scriptures or teachings of the other religions. All we teach Sanatana Dharma also, we teach all other religions. Not just Islam, we teach Christianity. I mean, we have studied and researched and taught about all other religions, and then we teach them the real history of India, that is the undistorted history of India, cultural, social, and the true history of India's freedom struggle. What we are taught in our textbooks today is mainly biased history. So we teach them the real history, which is based on facts and evidences and the current happenings. And we also provide them spiritual counseling based on yoga vidya and meditation and certain sadhanas. This is an overall comprehensive syllabus which is not, you know, it's not like somebody comes, you talk to them, you can revert them in 1 or 2 days or 1 or 2 hours. It's purely ideological. Just a 2 or 3 hours conversation is enough to bring someone back or be radicalized. For example, in the case of Ananda, she was brainwashed so ideologically, but it was purely ideological conversion. So in her case, it just took about 3 hours to make her realize the fallacies of what she was made to believe and adopt such a mindset and bring her back. But if there is some other animal involved, for example, love trap or narcotic jihad or different other traps, it takes time. You need to be very patient, and the person has to cooperate, the parents have to cooperate. So it's a very long process and a challenging one.
Yeah, hi. Hello.
Okay. One final question.
Sorry,
please, ma'am.
Hi. Preeti, you're from CNN News. I mean, now can you share some of your life stories, like aise hua aapke saath?
Hi everyone. First of all, hats off to the entire crew, because you have done such an awesome job. This film is actually closely related to my life and to my heart. I'm Dr. Anagha. I'm coming from Thrissur, Kerala. I'm a physiotherapist by profession and full-time worker of Arsha Vidya Samajam. Before 2 years, I too went through a stage of conversion. And like Charles Unnikrishnan, that character, my life was also changed upside down during my hostel days. Even though I was born and brought up in a practicing Hindu family, I was not at all aware about why I am doing all these things, or I was unaware about my dharma. And when I went for my higher studies, I left home and joined in Ernakulam College, and I stayed in a hostel there. And like Asifa, I do have many roommates. The conversion
promotion strategy what shown in the film is exact, not a big exaggeration. I must say that it is exact because they themselves create a situation and slowly inject or slowly started to say about their religion. Between a normal conversations itself, between as religion came a topic and they started ask questioning. Just like whatever you are asking. Actually, after seeing the film, I was really angry with you because you have acted so much best, okay? Just like that strategy means first they will ask questions, they will put you in confusion, and at that confused state, they will start criticizing our religion, that is our gods. The same exact questions, why are you having this much gods, why are you praying to a stone? So much questions they keep on asking, and because of we are unaware about why we are following all these things, or I was unaware about my dharma, so I couldn't answer any of those questions, and like Shalini Nikishan kept silent, I also kept silent. And after noticing, I felt that somewhere a degrading thought came to me that why I am not knowing these things, so I have to search on. So I came to my parents and asked these questions, what I faced from my friends. And they told me that just because our forefathers are doing all this, we are following the same. There was, it was obviously not convincing to me. I started searching in social medias also. But there also, I couldn't get any convincing answers because many explanations to slogans, etc. Are given. But what a common man has doubts, it was not given by any of the scholars. I couldn't get from any sources. So slowly, as depicted in the film itself, slowly Shalini started to ask questions. Okay, if this is wrong, then what is right? They make us to ask like that. And slowly I started asking, okay, then what is right? And they started to say that Allah is the only God. No others should be worshipped other than Allah. If you worship anybody rather than Allah, you will be put in hell. The first thing they will present. They are presenting their ideology in such a way that it is the best and it is the only truth. And slowly I started asking more questions. And when they notice that we are interested, they will give more books, that is Quran translations. That is for tafsir, and also they started to share videos of Zaki Naik and Imam Akbar et al. And actually these videos of those people made me actually radicalized. I was radicalized to that ideology because I slowly gradually my brain was fed up with this radicalized ideology. I was becoming a dangerous girl, I must say. Because I started to believe that none of the ideologies except Islam is right. And not only right, I started hating. Because it is said in the Quran itself, no consideration should be given to the kafirs. I'm not at all exaggerating it. There are many verses in the Quran itself how they consider or how Allah considers kafirs. So I was keep on studying this ideology, and slowly I became an anti-Hindu. And I must say that not only anti-Hindu, I became anti-human because my parents' tears, my family's tears was not at all bothering me. They kept on crying and fall to my feet and said, please don't go away. I started all practices that is followed by Muslim, that I was living like a Muslim woman. For about 5 years, I studied Islam, and at 2020, I was actually living like a Muslim woman. And at that time, you can just imagine, I was from a practicing Hindu family.
and puja and all are going on in my home. At that time, in upstairs, I am doing namas. And my parents couldn't tolerate what I am doing. They can't even stop me. But what to say? I am asking them questions and they can't answer any of them. So, they couldn't stop me from anything. They could only do one thing, was cry and say that, please don't go away. And at last they, my father and mother, I am not at all exaggerating, it was what I have gone through. My father and mother came to me and fall into my feet and said that, please don't go away. If you go away, we will commit suicide. No other options left between us. So, the one who gave to birth me, the one who loved me, the one who cared for me, I told to them, anyway, you are going to die as kafirs. You are going to be put in hell. It does not bother me if you commit suicide or not. I was really rude to them. Actually, this ideology, I must say, this ideology made me to say that, because it considers kafirs as just below animals. They consider kafirs as below animals. And it is also mentioned in the Quran that if your parents are non-Muslims or disbelievers, you does not have to obey your parents, or you does not have to consider your parents as, you does not have to consider them as parents. They were taught like, was taught like that, and let you guys decide whether this ideology or this behavior is anti-nation or anti-human. You guys decide. And I was so rude that not only to my parents, even to my cousin sister's child, when she at that time she was just 4, while the azam was given, I couldn't perform namas at time, and she was keep on coming to me and say, come, let's play, let's play. I got very angry and I pushed her down. Just see, she is just 4, she is not even knowing what I am going through. Is this anti-human or what? And after 5 or 6 years of Islamic study, I was completely against others. Only Allah or Muslims are right. Is this a tolerant thinking? It is intolerance, right? And by God's grace or my family's prayers, I was able to come to Ashwavidya Samajam and meet Acharya ji. And as Vishali ji said, the ideology which I was carrying in my head for the 6 years, 6 long years, he proved me, Acharya ji proved me to be false within just 3 hours. It is the only course, Adhyatmika Shastram course. So I must say that I was escaped just because my parents' prayers or whatever it is. But what the feeling showed, what strategy they try to expose in front of public is real. Please don't say that it is some agenda or what. You are playing actually with thousands of girls' lives. Please do believe that. After coming to Ashwavidya Samajam, I also met so many cases, and you asked how they are becoming anti-nation, right? Some of the students from US,
came to us, and he was highly radicalized in this ideology, and he was asking his Pakistani and Afghanistani friends that, when are you coming to attack India? Why are you not demolishing the temples in India? Is this anti-nation or what? Is this anti-human or what? Actually, I am not saying that all Muslims are wrong or all Hindus are right or all Christians are wrong. I am not at all saying that. But this ideology surely, definitely contains some of the verses or that makes anti-human or anti-national. And we must say that a strong caucus is functioning all over the world to convert people, to radicalize them, to recruit them to this ISIS or any other terrorist groups. And it is a fact. And this feeling is actually, I must bow down before you because you have been that much sincere to that topic. And I couldn't watch the film. I watched the film actually by holding brief. I want to say that each and every scene, I want to cry loudly. Hats off to you guys. Thank you for taking this topic and exposing it before the public and bringing it to the big screen. Thank you all, and also I must thank you, my Acharyaji, my Guruji, Acharya Manoji and Ashvidya Samaja. Because of them only I could come back to my dharma. And so many, regardless of how many threats or whatever crisis we are facing, we, some of them in this society, we are ready to even give or surrender our lives for saving our sisters, daughters, all them, not only girls, all them. We are ready, and once of all, thank you, everybody.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Dr. Anna, for that very powerful sharing.
I just want to say one thing. She became very emotional. A lot of girls here have become very emotional. They are not used to speaking in front of media. So please use your discretion when you use the speech. Because I know that even, you know, this speech can be misinterpreted. This speech can also be labeled as agenda or whatever. So please use your discretion. And she's just poured her heart out, and you can see so many other girls are getting emotional. So please.
Vipulji, I've been waiting for a long time. Vipulji, my name is Bella. I'm from the Times of India newspaper. I have just one question for you. Even if we take your film at face value, we do not ask for numbers, we do not make a controversy, whether it is 3 or 32,000. Does it please you somewhere in the core of your heart